Hello students, how are you all? I hope you all are good and well, and I am also feeling well. Now students, we are going to start our new topic, quadratic equations. See beta, this is chapter number 4. NCERT textbook, beta. First of all, we have to complete NCERT textbook, then we will go for extra questions. Okay, now see beta, the topic name is quadratic equation. Now see, beta, first of all, when we are starting the topic, first we should be aware of the title. What is quadratic and what is equation? Only in that case we will be able to understand what is a quadratic equation and how we can resolve the problems associated with quadratic equations, beta. Okay, now see beta, the history behind quadratic equation is totally messed up. You will say, sir, why are you saying so? But I will give you the examples why I said so later on. First, we should know the title of the topic. Okay, we will discover why we are calling these equations quadratic equations. Okay, beta. See, number one, the first term here is quadratic. What does quadratic means? We have earlier studied in chapter 2 quadratic polynomials. The word quadratic, from there you can understand quadratic means two. Two means, do you remember, polynomials having degree 2 are quadratic polynomials. In the same way, beta, equations having degree 2 are quadratic equations. For this word quadratic, the justification is given by degree 2. Okay, beta. Now, what about equation? Okay, beta, let the lecture be a little bit longer, but I am going to tell about the facts about the equation. Okay, beta, see, it will boost up your basic knowledge. See, what I am saying, the word equation, what is the funda behind the word equation? See, beta, in older times, very frankly, I am telling you the concept in two theories. What is older theory, you can say, and this is modern theory. Very frankly, beta, try to understand older theory. See, when I was a student, my math teacher, Mr. Sanjeev Mishra, I was taught by Mr. Sanjeev Mishra, sir, mathematics in class 10, he told us this theory. In many books, this theory is little bit written there. But now, the modern theory is everywhere. See, beta? Now see, older theory. In older theory, the term equation was like this. When we are comparing two things like this, beta, or you can say we are connecting two quantities with the comparison symbol. What are the comparison symbols? Greater than, less than, greater than, equal to, less than, equal to, not equal to, and so on, approximately, equal to, such like. These all are comparison symbols, and according to older theory, when we are comparing two quantities using these symbols, or you can say we are connecting two quantities using these symbols, the formed expression is known as equation. See, beta, What is this? Suppose I am writing x5 plus 2x greater than 9y. Suppose I am writing x square plus 2x greater than 9y. This is all was called as equation. Comparison of two quantities. And according to Older theory, the equation was classified into two type of equations. One was balanced, and the second was unbalanced. You got my point, beta? See, balanced, equations and unbalanced equations. See, suppose in my hand I am having 5 kg weight. 5 kg weight. And in my this end hand I have has, I am having, 5 kg sugar. This is 5 kg weight. This is 5 kg sugar. How the hands will treat? They will be like this. They will be like this at the same level. It means this time hands are balanced. What does it mean? See, beta, when the two quantities are connected with this symbol, the symbol stands for equal to. You all know, you all are smart students, and I know you all can understand. This symbol stands for equal to. It means I am writing x square plus 5y is equal to 9y square. Whatever is, this quantity, if the symbol is here, equal to, 5 is equal to 5, weight 5 kg, sugar 5 kg, balanced. This will be called as balanced equation. This was called as, okay, in older times. Now, in the case of unbalanced, here is 5 kg weight and here is 10 kg sugar. It will be like this, yes or no? Done. If here is 5 kg weight and here is 1 kg sugar, it will be like this. Unbalanced. This position and this position both are unbalanced, but this position is balanced. It means in older times, unbalanced equation was when these symbols were used like this, this and this. Okay, all other symbols other than equal to were used. In that case, the equation was called as unbalanced equation. This is beta older theory. It's an older theory. Okay, done. See, beta, when we compare two quantities, okay, in that case equation is formed. Okay, beta. And there were two, the classification of equation was balanced and unbalanced equation. Done. Now you can take the screenshot. Done, beta. Now see. Now it comes to modern theory. I am roughing it. I think you all have taken the screenshot. Now we will discuss the modern theory of equations. According to modern theory, see, beta, in English there is a prefix, equa, which stands for equal. There is a prefix equa, which stands for equal. But in older theory, equation were comparison. One left hand side were larger, right was smaller, and still they were called as equations. It means there was a conflict. And this conflict was sorted out. As you all know, mathematicians are very simple and very, very, very simple person and very nice persons. That's why they went according to the English consideration, and they made the change in the terminology like this. In the modern theory, what does equation means? Equation means when we are comparing two equal quantities in written form. Equation is formed like this. X square plus 5y is equal to 9. What does it mean? In older times, the equation which was called as balanced in modern times is called as equation. You got my point? In older times, the equation which was classified as balanced equation, in modern time, it just became equation. Okay, beta. Now see, then what about unbalanced equation. Unbalanced equation was later on named as inequation. What was the name given to this? Inequation. Okay, beta. Like this, x square plus 5y greater than 9. X square plus 5y greater than 9. Here, this is unbalanced equation according to older theory, and according to modern theory, this is inequation. Okay, beta, I think the things are clear to you all now. So, beta, please go for the modern theory. Only keep in mind the modern theory. Equation, what is equation? When two equal quantities are compared, when two equal expressions are compared, then the equation is formed. Okay, beta, done. Now you all know quadratic equation. Quadratic equations are the equations having degree 2. Equation means when two equal quantities are compared and where the degree of all the both the quantities is 2. Okay, beta. See, beta. Suppose I am writing the standard form of quadratic equation. First thing, is it quadratic? In both sides, the degree is 2. Yes, it's a quadratic. Then, is it an equation? Oh, there is symbol equal to. What does it mean? It means this is a quadratic equation. And see, beta, why I wrote you, give you this example? Because this is the standard form of quadratic equation. You got my point, beta? This is the standard form of a quadratic equation. See, quadratic polynomial in one variable, it just changed into the form of an equation. Okay, beta? See, in quadratic equations, variable number of variables may vary, but according to our curriculum, we will discuss only the quadratic equations in one variable. That's why this is the standard form of quadratic equation we are going to discuss. In your higher classes, you will learn many more things about quadratic equation and many more things are elaborated there. Okay, beta? Done? Now I think you all know what is a quadratic equation. Now see, beta. Earlier in the lecture, in this lecture, I used word that who gave the concept of quadratic equation, up to which part of that history which we were able to tackle with the modern quadratic equation, the fundas we are using in the modern time were introduced by whom and what was the concept. Okay, see beta, why this is little bit complex to exactly say who gave the funda. See, in many books it is said that Babylonians gave the fundamental of quadratic equation. In many books, even on the net, if you go and search, it is said that Babylonians give the funda of quadratic equation. But many mathematicians says that they were only to able to find numbers. Sum and product. See beta, find two numbers. Many mathematicians states that Babylonians were able to only find two numbers, their sum and product, and then make a relation between them, as we have discussed in exercise 2.2, how to find the zeros by factorization. Okay, it was given by Babylonians. It means you can say splitting the middle term idea was generated from their minds. Okay, beta, they did this all in 400 BC. Okay, they did this all in 400 BC. Done. See, later on in many books, it is written that Mr. Pythagoras, you all know Pythagoras? Mr. Pythagoras, you all know Mr. Pythagoras? Pythagoras theorem, hypotenuse square is equal to base square plus perpendicular square. We have learned in earlier classes, okay, in chapter 8 trigonometry. In chapter 6, you will go through the actual proof of the Pythagoras theorem in 10th class. Okay, beta, see. He was a Greek mathematician. Okay, he was a Greek mathematician. He started to work on the geometric proof of quadratic equations in 500 BC. See, beta, in 500 BC, Pythagoras tried to give the geometric proof of quadratic equations. How to deal with the quadratic equation? Geometry, using geometry. Okay, he tried to find the area of something. Are you getting my point? See, Babylonians, Pythagoras. Now see, two, three more names are there. And two, three are Indians are also there. I think you can take the screenshot. You have taken? Done? Should we move on? Now see, beta. Now everyone was struggling to find the solution of the quadratic equations. And why Indians are behind? Indian mathematician, Indian minds are never behind. Mr. Brahmagupta. You all know Mr. Brahmagupta? You have listened the name of Mr. Brahmagupta in many books in your earlier classes. Now see, beta, in Mr. Brahmagupta in 600 BC jumped into the war. Jumped into the war of solving quadratic equations. Okay, jumped into the war of solving quadratic equations. What did he do? He tried to find out. He tried to generate a formula to deal with quadratic equations. You got my point? Why Indians are never behind? Indians are not followers, they are leaders. And that's why I say Mr. Brahmagupta jumped into the war. Indians will solve the funda of quadratic equation. Then see, beta, Mr. Sridharacharya. See, beta, this is very, very important name. This is very, very important name in the field of quadratic equation. See, beta, he tried to solve it geometrically. Okay? He tried to solve it geometrically, but Mr. Sridharacharya generated a formula to deal with the concept of quadratic equations. How? Using algebraical operations. You got my point? Beta, this is Indian mind. Everyone trying to find out the solutions from here and there, and then Mr. Sridharacharya, then an Indian, and I am proud to be an Indian, jumped into the field and gave us the most appropriate method, which is applicable in any kind of quadratic equation. See, beta, in many, many, many questions further we will doing in the chapter, their middle term, completing the whole square, lots of methods are there, they all will fail. But the only method which will work is for the solution of quadratic equation is given by an Indian. It was given by an Indian. Okay, Mr. Sridharacharya. आचार्य है. लेटर ऑन मिस्टर भास्कर, मिस्टर भास्कर टू, ही जंप्ड इनटू द फील्ड एंड ही गेव हिज फॉर्मूला अ नेम, अ नेम टू हिज फॉर्मूला. एंड व्हाट डज इट ही, व्हाट डिड ही से, ही सेड दिस फॉर्मूला इज क्वाड्रेटिक फॉर्मूला. व्हाट इज दिस, दिस इज क्वाड्रेटिक फॉर्मूला. मिस्टर ब्रह्म, मिस्टर भास्कर गेव द नेम टू द फॉर्मूला दैट दिस इज क्वाड्रेटिक फॉर्मूला. एंड सी बेटा, इन द मॉडर्न एरिया इरा दिस फॉर्मूला इज वेरी फेमस, दिस फॉर्मूला इज वेरी 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 फेमस एज श्रीधराचार्य फॉर्मूला. यू गॉट माई पॉइंट मिस्टर श्रीधराचार्य फॉर्मूला. डन, ओके. सी बेटा, लॉट्स ऑफ मेथड आर देयर. सी बेबीलोनियंस ऑल्सो नोन फॉर द कंसेप्ट ऑफ कंप्लीटिंग द होल स्क्वेयर, ऑल्सो नोन फॉर द कंप्लीटिंग द होल स्क्वेयर मेथड वॉज गिवन बाय बेबीलोनियंस. इट इज ऑल्सो ए सैड, इट इज ऑल्सो सैड टोल्ड थ्योरी. ठीक है, दीज आर द, दिस इज द हिस्ट्री बिहाइंड द क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशंस बेटा. नाउ हु विल डिसाइड विच गेव, हु गेव द एग्जैक्ट थिंग्स. Quadratic equations, many more. Mr. Al-Khwarizmi, I have introduced you, Mr. Al-Khwarizmi, earlier in polynomial chapter. He also, Mr. Al-Khwarizmi, who gave the word of algebra from the book Kitab al-Jabr. Okay, you all know, you have watched my earlier videos, Introduction to Polynomials. He also jumped into the field in 800 BC. In 800 BC. And one person, Abraham Hianasia. Okay. He wrote a book, Liber Ambrodem, in which the concept of quadratic equation is also there. Okay, beta. Now I'm going to rough the history. You can take the screenshot. I think you all have taken the screenshot, beta. Now see, this is the, these are the persons, these are the famous personality which are who are behind the concept of quadratic equations we are learning in modern era. We are learning in modern era. Okay, beta. Now see, this was the whole basics behind the quadratic equation. What is quadratic? Having power 2. What is equation? Symbols equal means balanced, equal quantities, equal expressions having degree 2 are compared, are quadratic equations. Okay, beta. Standard form I have already wrote to you, ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. Okay, beta. Now see, without wasting the time, see, we have not wasted our time during the introduction. Many students told me, texted me, sir, in every video you are saying without wasting time and then start. It's my hobby, it's my habit. One student commented to me, sir, the whenever you are teaching, the word you use, dusht, should be there in the lecture. Sorry, beta, that is the thing we happen, that happened physically in front of you, all to make you little bit comfortable. But now the whole India is watching our videos, you know, whole India is watching Prince videos. That's why we have to be very sophisticated here. Okay, now jokes apart, without wasting the time, we are going to start chapter 4, exercise 4.1. Exercise 4.1. See beta, in exercise 4.1, one thing is there, that in this exercise we have to just form quadratic equations. We have to classify whether this equation is quadratic equation or not, and then with the given conditions which may be practical, we have to deal with the conditions and then form the quadratic equations. Okay beta, very 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 simple exercise and very 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 interesting exercise. This exercise will build your base for the further exercises, and the whole chapter will be a fun for you. I promise, I am with you, you come with me, we all can do it. Not me alone, not you alone, we all can do it. Okay, beta? Now, we are going to start exercise 4.1. Okay, done. Exercise 4.1, question number 1. See, beta, I am directly starting the exercise. Why? Because basic exercise is there. If I start with giving some examples and so on, not required. Exercise 4.1 from the very first question, you will get whole the concept cleared because from my point of view, you all have learned chapter 2 very well. It's gonna be a fun. Okay, beta? It's gonna be a fun. See, exercise 4.1, question number 1, part first. What is given here? Here an expression is given. Now what I am saying, this expression or equation is given. And what we have to do, we have to check whether it is a quadratic equation or not. See beta, this is already an equation. Sorry, this is already an equation. And what we have to justify, whether it is a quadratic equation or not. See beta, what is the standard form? Ax square bx plus c is equal to 0. And we have to solve it and try to take it to the destination. If it is approachable there, then it is quadratic equation. Otherwise, no. Done. Now see beta. A plus b whole square. A square plus b square plus 2ab. Multiply inside 2x minus 6. 2x minus 6. Got my points, beta? See, a plus b whole square, the quantity, the identity we have learnt in class 9. Now see what is going on. This is x square plus 1 plus 2x. And what is here? 2x minus 6. Try to shift all the right hand side terms to the left side. Why? Because we want to give this the standard form. In the very beginning, I just told you that we will try to make the equation like this. Okay? For this, we are going to shift all the right hand terms to the left. And once you see, whenever we shift the quantities, whenever we change the sides, the symbols of the terms are changed. Okay? Now see, x square is only here. No one is liking x square, but I am liking x square because it will give us the quadratic equation. Now see, 2x, 2x cancelled, yes or no? Done. These are cancelled. And what is this? 1 and 6, 7. Yes or no? See beta, it was x plus 1 whole square. A square plus b square plus 2ab. And when we multiply 2 inside, distributive property, 2x minus 6. We shift it toward that. These are cancelled. X square plus 7 is equal to 0. And one more thing. This is quadratic equation. Yes. Now you will say, sir, this is not this kind of. See beta, can I write this? X square plus 0x plus 7 is equal to 0. Why? Because x term is not there. That's why I can write x square plus 0 plus 7. See, one more thing. Whenever the quadratic equation is this of this form, x square plus a is equal to 0. What does it mean? No x term is there, only square and 0. This is called as pure quadratic equations. This is called as pure quadratic equations. You got my point, beta? Quadratic equations. This was quadratic equation standard form. And what is this? Purely quadratic equation having degree, power of x as only 2 or 0 is here. xA means a into x raised to power 0. Okay, done, beta? Question number 1, part first. Now you take the screenshot. I have taken, you all have taken the screenshot. Now, beta, we are going to start question number 1, part second. What this equation is called as? Pure quadratic equations. Purely quadratic equations. Okay, beta. I think all students are very attentive and paying attention to the videos. प्लीज बेटा यू ऑल हैव टू बी वेरी अटेंटिव, दिस इज द क्रिटिकल टाइम वी आर फेसिंग, बट वी शुड शो दैट वी आर इंडियंस एंड वी विल मेक कोरोना लूज. ओके, वी ऑल कैन डू इट, नॉट मी, नॉट यू, वी ओनली वी कैन डू इट. नाउ क्वेश्चन नंबर वन पार्ट सेकेंड. सी बेटा, हेयर इज इक्वेशन एक्स स्क्वेयर माइनस टू एक्स इज इक्वल टू माइनस टू इंटू थ्री माइनस एक्स. ओके, एक्स इफ एनी स्टेटमेंट इज प्रॉब्लम इज देयर, डू नॉट गेट पैनिक. वंस अगेन आई एम सेइंग दीज वर्ड्स आई एम यूजिंग वंस अगेन. सी व्हाट वी हैव टू डू हेयर, वी हैव टू फर्स्ट सिंप्लीफाई दिस ना, एक्स स्क्वेयर माइनस टू एक्स माइनस टू इंटू थ्री माइनस. ओके, नाउ सी, दिस इज एक्स स्क्वेयर, दिस इज माइनस टू एक्स, मल्टीप्लाई दिस इन साइड माइनस सिक्स विद दिस प्लस टू एक्स. ओके, हेयर इज एक्स स्क्वेयर, हेयर इज माइनस टू एक्स, कैन आई चेंज दिस टूवर्ड दिस टू एक्स एंड वेन दिस इज शिफ्टेड हेयर प्लस सिक्स. ओके, वेन वी शिफ्ट द साइड्स, ओ सॉरी, चेंज द साइड्स, द शिफ्टेड क्वांटिटीज विल चेंज देयर साइन. दिस इज एक्स स्क्वेयर माइनस फोर एक्स प्लस सिक्स इज इक्वल टू जीरो. एक्स स्क्वेयर माइनस फोर एक्स प्लस सिक्स इज इक्वल टू जीरो. ओ सॉरी, यस, अ ह्यूज यस, अ बिग यस फॉर दिस इक्वेशन टू बी अ क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन. व्हाई? एक्स स्क्वेयर ए एक्स स्क्वेयर प्लस बी एक्स प्लस सी, इट इज द स्टैंडर्ड फॉर्म एंड दिस इक्वेशन इज फॉलोइंग द स्टैंडर्ड फॉर्म, दैट्स व्हाई इट इज क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन. ओके बेटा, डन, रिमूव ऑन. क्वेश्चन नंबर वन पार्ट थ्री. सी बेटा, प्लीज डू नॉट डू एनी कैलकुलेशन रॉन्ग, बिकॉज यू ऑल नो दिस इज द वेरी सिंपल फंडा हाउ टू डिस्कवर वेदर दिस इज अ क्वाड्रेटिक और नॉट. बट ड्यूरिंग कैलकुलेशन इफ अ सिंगल मिस्टेक इज देयर, दैट विल सफर यू अ लॉट, दैट विल सफर यू अ लॉट. सो बेटा, बी अटेंटिव एवरी टाइम. सी, दिस इंटू दिस इज इक्वल टू दिस इंटू दिस. When we multiply these, distributive law, x into x, x square, x into 1, x, minus 2 into this, minus 2x, minus 2 into this, minus 2 is equal to this into this, x square, this into this, 3x, this into this, minus x, this into this, minus 3. Okay, beta, now see. If we shift these toward this, first you change both the, simplify both the sides. X square minus 2 plus minus x, minus 2 plus 1, minus 1, minus 2. X square 3 minus 2, 1, 2, minus 3. Now these both are sides simplified. X square minus 2x minus 2. Now what will be our next step? We will shift all the quantities, all the terms of the right towards left. So beta, when we shift this, it is minus x square, minus 2x and plus 3 is equal to 0. Now you see, is something is removable? Yes! Minus 2 minus 2 minus 4x, minus 2 plus 3 plus 1 is equal to 0. Is it a quadratic equation? No. Why? Degree of the equation is not 2. Degree of equation is not 2 here. That's why this is not the quadratic equation. You got my point, beta? Done. Now what will we do? We will go for the next question. Done. Take the screenshot. Done. I think you all have taken the screenshot. Now we are going to solve question number 1, part 4th. Question number 1, part 4th. What is here? X minus 3, 2x plus 1. x into x plus 5. X into x plus 5. Okay, beta, see. Start solving. How will you simplify? Distribution, multiply, multiply. X into this, 2x square, x into this, plus x. This into this, minus 6x. This into this, minus 3. X square plus 5x, am I right? This into this, this into this. Done. Now shift. Before shifting, simplify. Minus 5x, x square plus 5x. Here is 2x square. Shift this. And this. Am I right? Am I right, students? You have to catch this. Okay, then 2 minus 1, 1. Minus 5, minus 5, minus 10. Here is minus 3 is equal to 0. Yes or no? Beta, is it a quadratic equation? I will say yes. And how many of you with me raise your hands and make some noise that yes, it is a quadratic equation. Yes, it's a quadratic equation. Done, beta, take the screenshot. Okay, now see question number 1, part 5th. Now some students will say, sir, these are very simple and you are still solving all the parts. You are wasting your time. No, beta, I am not wasting your time and I am not here to waste your time. Because we have to target all kind of students. So beta, please keep patience. Within 2-3 minutes, all parts will be solved. Okay, see. Fifth part. 2x minus 1, x minus 3. X plus 5, x minus 1, yes or no? Okay, x minus 1. Now try to solve this. 2x into this, 2x square, minus 6x, minus x, plus 3. Am I right? If there is any mistake, you have to be responsible over that because you should not commit any mistake. Okay? X square minus x, 5x minus 5. Am I right? Done. Simplify. Minus 7x plus 3. X square plus 4x minus 5. Now what will we do? We will shift all the right terms towards left. 2x square minus 7x plus 3. Minus x square minus 4x plus 5 is equal to 0. Yes or no? Now see beta, 2x square minus x square. Okay. Minus 7, minus 4, minus 11. Am I right? Done. 3 plus 5, 8 is equal to 0. What will you say? Use yes. Yes, this is a quadratic equation. Yes, this is a quadratic equation. Take the screenshot, beta. Done. Now we will go for next question. Question number 1, part 6. Okay. Now see, what is the statement of question number 1, part 6? It is x square plus 3x plus 1. X minus 2 whole square. I will say no. This is not a quadratic equation. How? See beta. X square plus 3x plus 1. A minus b whole square. A square plus b square minus 2ab. Why did I write? Because many students can commit mistakes. So beta, you know why minus 4x here? Because minus 2ab was the term. X square plus 3x plus 1. Shift minus x square plus 4 plus 4x. Am I right? No. Here it will be minus. Okay beta, jagte raho. Next. x square minus x square cancelled. 3x plus 4x, 7x. What is this? 1 minus 4 minus 3. Is it a quadratic equation? Is it a quadratic equation? See, beta. Tell me. Hurry up. Make some noise for no. No, sir. This is not the quadratic equation. Okay, students. Take the screenshot. I am little bit faster in these. Why? Because these are very simple and you all are brilliant students. Class 10 Princeans. Done? Next. See, question number 1, part next. Question number 1, part next. Statement is x plus 2 whole cube. X plus 2 whole cube. First, 7th part. Is equal to 2x into x square minus 1. What we have to check whether it is a quadratic or not. See, a plus b whole cube, you all know. A plus b whole cube. A cube, b cube, 3a square b, 3ab square. If you are not aware of this identity, go to the channel and watch exercise 2.5 remaining portion for class 9. All the identities of cube, square and triple squares, all are mentioned there. Please beta, if you are having little bit loose hand in the quantities, you can watch that video. That will surely help you. Okay beta, now see what is this. And one more thing, students, near about 500 students in the class are watching the videos. Students here, we the team prints are doing a lot of hard work. And the team, and very true beta, the team, technical team of Prince is too much hardworking. Which teachers came here for 4 hours, 5 hours and shoot our videos and give them. And then uploading the correction work and many things, the thumbnail preparation, each and everything they do up to the 4 a.m., 5 a.m. in the morning. And exactly at 9, again they are here. I appreciate them and salute to them. So beta, please, you all should like our videos to boost us. Okay? Each and every one of the team member is working very hard only for you students. So beta, please, your appreciation, your good comments and your likes and views give us motivation. Okay, beta? So please do not forget to like and give positive comments. Question number 7 beta. X plus 2 whole cube. A plus B whole cube, you all know. A cube, B cube. 3 A square B, 3 AB square. Multiply 2X cube. Minus 2x. Okay, beta. A cube, B cube, 3a square b, 3ab square. Okay, now see. X cube plus 8. 3 to the 6x square. 4, 3 is a 12x. 2x cube minus 2x. Here is x cube. Plus 8 plus 6x square plus 12x. Shift. Minus 2x cube plus 2x is equal to 0. Yes or no? It will happen. It will surely happen. X cube minus 2x cube minus x cube. 6x square is the only one. 6x square. 12x, 2x, 14x. Yes or no? Done, and the plus 8 is remaining alone is equal to 0. 3, 2, 1, 0. Okay, see beta, is it a quadratic polynomial? Is it a quadratic polynomial? Make some noise. Yes? No. This is not the quadratic polynomial. Okay, students, I think you all are aware that an equation will be the quadratic equation only if the degree is 2. But here the degree is 3. That's why this is not a quadratic equation. Done, beta. Very good. Take the screenshot. Then we will do the last question. Sorry, last part of this question. You have taken the screenshot? Then move on. The last part is part 8. Okay. Oh, part 8. See, beta, this is the 8th part. Question number 1. X cube minus 4x square minus x plus 1. X minus 2 whole cube. X minus 2 whole cube. See, beta. This, minus this, this. A minus B whole square. A minus B whole square. Sorry, whole cube. Sorry for that, I called it square, it is cube. A minus B whole cube. What is the A minus whole cube? A cube minus B cube minus 3A square B plus 3AB square. Yes or no? Okay, if you are not having good hand in the algebraic identities, go to the class 9th video, exercise 2.5, remaining questions, all identities are solved there, okay? Now see beta, what it will be? I am writing here, a cube minus b cube, 3a square b plus 3ab square, okay? A cube minus b cube, 3a square b, 3ab square. Now see beta, x cube minus 4x square minus x plus 1. Here is x cube minus 8. 3 to the 6 x square. 3, 4 the 12 x plus 12 x. X square minus 4x square, x cube, sorry. Minus 4x square minus x plus 1. Shift toward this. I shifted all these and changed the signs. Now see beta, x cube cancelled. X cube, yes or no? Very good. Minus 4x cube plus 6x square. 2x square. Minus x. Minus 12x. Minus 13x. Plus 1 plus 8. Plus 9 is equal to 0. Yes or no? I use yes with me. Everyone have to say yes, it is a quadratic equation. Okay beta, take the sorry. Now take the screenshot. This is the portion of identities we have used. I have written there. I think you all have taken the screenshot. Now we will go for the next questions. Okay, we will go for the next questions. And what are the next questions beta? In question number 2, exercise 4.1, what we have to do, we have to make only quadratic equation. Some conditions are given there beta. What we have to decide, whether these conditions are able to form a quadratic equation or not. Okay beta, we have to just make the quadratic equations. In next exercises, we will all learn how to solve the quadratic equations by different methods. See beta, question number 2, following, represent the following situations in the form of a quadratic equation. Represent the following conditions, situations in the form of a quadratic equation. First part beta, what is first part? First part is, where is the first part going? Click. The area of the rectangular plot is 528, okay. Length of the plot is one more than the twice of breadth. Everyone please read the statement. I think you all are reading. See beta, what is given here? Here is the condition of a rectangle is given. See beta, what is this? Length. What is this? Breadth. I should raise the temperatures. See beta, the question number 2 part first is associated with a problem related to rectangles. You all know what is a rectangle. You all are in 10th class. In the 5th class, the rectangles were introduced. That's why you all know what is a rectangle. I will not explain what is a rectangle here. Rectangle is this, where length, breadth, a quadrilateral having opposite sides equal, all the angles of the quadrilateral are right angles. Okay, now see, what is the condition given? First you try to understand, then I will write all the things, how to express this question to get perfect 4 by 4 marks. See, first you try to understand. What is given here? It is given that its area, what is area beta? L into B. And L into B is given 528 meter square. Yes or no? It is given in the equation that this is a rectangle with area 528 and condition, relation between length and breadth is this, that length is double of breadth plus 1. Try to understand what is given. Length is one more than the double of breadth. Suppose I am Rajiv, I am having 100 rupees. I am having 100 rupees and you are student. You are, suppose you are Dash. And you can fill your name in the Dash, na? Okay. Suppose I am Rajiv, I am having 100 rupees and Mr. or Ms. Dash having one more than twice of mine money. Mine money is 100, its twice is 200 and one more than 200 is 201. It means Dash has 201 rupees. I am having 100 and you are having twice of mine plus one means you are having 201 rupees. Got my point? I am having 100 and you are having one more than the twice of mine money. What does it mean? You all are richer than me. Okay, done. You all are richer than me. All dusha. Now see beta, area is L into B. Area is 520 meter square. If we assume that breadth is x meters, then the what length length will be? Sorry, I wrote here. Breadth is x meter. Then the length will be one more than the twice of breadth. Yes or no? Yes or no? Okay, beta. Done. Now see question number 2. Solution of question number 2. What we have to write? Let the breadth of rectangle be x meters. Be x meters. Beta, always remember, you should not leave the quantity alone without its unit. Okay? Then length, then its length will be, what it will be? One more than twice of breadth. Yes or no? The length will be one more than twice of its breadth. Done, beta? Very good. Now see, what is given condition? According to condition, what is condition? Area is 528 meter square. Yes or no? Area is 528 meter square. And what is area? L into B is 528 meter square. Okay. What is L? What is L? 2x plus 1 into what is B? X. 528. Now multiply 2x square plus x, 528. Yes or no? Okay. From here, I am shifting this towards left. The equation will be C beta. the equation will be 2x square plus x minus 528 is equal to 0. This is our answer. This is our answer. Final solution for the problem. The condition which was given. The given condition was there is a rectangle having area 522 meter square and the relation between length and breadth is that length is one more than the twice of its breadth. Length is one more than the twice of its breadth. It means if the length is 10, breadth will be one more than the twice of 10. 21. Okay, beta. Done. This is the final solution for question number 2, part 1st. Take the screenshot. Take its screenshot. Done, beta. Okay. Now, question number 2, part 2nd. Question number 2, part 2nd. What is given here? What is given here, beta? See. The product of two consecutive positive integers is 306. Product of two consecutive positive integers is find. We need to find the integers. Okay. We have to make a condition that product of two consecutive integers is consecutive. What does it consecutive means? It means A and then A plus 1 and then A minus 1. These are the numbers. These are consecutive numbers. These are consecutive numbers. If I write A plus 2, suppose 51, 52, 53, 50. These are 4 consecutive numbers. These are 3 consecutive numbers. These are 2 consecutive numbers. What does it mean? If we add 1 to a number, then its next number is obtained and both numbers are consecutive. What does it mean? Consecutive means the number appearing one after one, one after another. Suppose 20 and I want to make a consecutive number 1 less than 20, that will be 90, that will be 19. Okay. If I want to find a number one more than the consecutive number one more than the 20, it will be 21. Okay, beta. What does it mean? Consecutive numbers means which are appearing one behind other. Yeah, or we can say adding one, we can get next consecutive number and so on. Okay. Now see what is given here in question number 2, part 2nd. Part 2nd. What is condition? Product of two consecutive numbers is 306. Product of two consecutive numbers is 306. Let the first positive integer be x. First positive integer be x. The next can be x plus 1 as well as x minus 1. Choice is yours, whichever you want to take, you can take. I am taking it here, then the second positive integer will be x plus 1. Here I am taking the next number 2x. Okay, now what is the condition given? According to given condition, what it will be? It will be that product of two consecutive numbers is 306. X into x plus 1. Product means multiplication of the numbers. X into x plus 1. X square plus x is equal to 306. And if we shift 306 towards left, it will be minus and is equal to 0. This is the final expression. Yes, we formed a quadratic condition here, a quadratic equation here. See beta, once again I am repeating the same question. It was very simple. Suppose, let me give you an example. I want to ask you, what are the two consecutive numbers if their product is 90? You all will say, sir, 9 into 10, 9 into 10 is 90. 9 into 10 is 90. In the same case, we were given that there is a number and its product with its consecutive, its next or previous product of two consecutive numbers was 306. We wrote first is x, second is x plus 1, then their product x into x plus 1 became 306. Became 306. Take the screenshot, beta. It is very simple. Okay, it was very simple. Done. Okay. Now see question number 2, part 3rd. Question number 2, part 3rd. See, what is given here? See, beta, what I am going to say you, age question. Whenever the question of based on ages are there, I am giving you a panacea. What is panacea? Panacea means Rambaan ilaj. Panacea means Rambaan ilaj. See, beta, in 99.99% questions based on ages are very simple, and the panacea for them is consider the age of given persons at present level. At present level, you have to consider their age, assume their age. The number of persons are there, it doesn't matter, just you consider their age according to the condition. Present age, see, statement you have read or you are reading, just read. Rohan's mother is 26 older than him. This is obvious. Mother is always elder than the son or daughter. Yes or no? Is there anyone out of you who is elder than your father or mother? No one is there. Now see, the condition is there that Rohan's mother is 26 years older than him. Okay, now let Rohan's present age be x years. See, beta, what I consider, let the Rohan's present age be x years. Then what will happen? Mother's age will be x plus 26. Because she is 26 more than Rohan. One student, last year I asked the student, sir, suppose Rohan is X, then what the mother will be? He said X plus 26. Sir, 26 X years. No, beta, this is wrong. Only this, because these are unlike, there is no operation between them. The student by mistake multiplied. I don't know in which world he was. He just multiplied x plus 26 to 26x. So do not go such kind of silly mistakes. You are Princeans. Okay? And your presentation, your behavior, all things should be like a prince. Okay? Done. Now see, beta. Let's present age be x years. Then his mother's present age be x plus 26 years. Yes or no? X plus 26 years. See, beta, the product of their age is 3 years from now will be. Okay. Now condition is start. See, beta, condition is for future. For future, suppose I am today 25 years, okay? I am 25 years old now. What my age will be after 3 years? I will be 28. Yes or no? What does it mean? 25 plus 3, okay? Now see. After 3 years, markers are disturbing the class. After 3 years, Rohan's age will be x plus 3 years, yes or no? X plus 3 years, yes or no? Done? Then, his mother's age will be x plus 26 plus 3 years, that is x plus 29. X plus 29 years. Okay, beta. After 3 years, Rohan will be x plus 3 and mother will be x plus 26 plus 3. X plus 29 years. Now, what is condition? Now, according to condition, what is according to condition? Their product x plus 3, x plus 29. It will be, what was 360? I do not remember. I think it was 360. See beta, what is the condition given here? After 3 years, product of their ages will be 360. Okay, it means, these are the present ages, plus 3 after 3 years. Plus 3 after 3 years. After 3 years, their ages are this and this. And their product will be 360. This into this, it will be 360. Now multiply beta, x square, 29x, 3x, plus 87. Shift this towards like this, minus 360 is equal to 0, yes or no? So beta, what the equation will be? X square plus 32x, what is here? Minus, subtract, 280, what it will be? Tell me, what is this? 360 minus 87. See beta, try to understand the calculations also. In between the lecture, I will try to tell you the concepts. Those I do use during calculations. This is 360, this is 87. I will subtract 100 from this. What I will get? 260. But this is 13 less now, it means 13 will be added to the 260. What it will be? 273. See beta, 87 is 13 less than 100. I was to subtract 87, but I subtract 100. I got 260, but 13 is extra there now, which was removed. By chance, when I subtracted 100 here, 13 more was subtracted, I gave 13 into 2, this condition, it is 273. Okay, slowly you will learn these concepts. I will tell you this concept in separate video, okay? Try to my best to give you a separate video for class 9, 10, 11, 12, calculation, how to make the calculations easier. This is the condition we got beta, this is the output, this is the answer. Okay, once again, present age x plus 26. After 3 years, x plus 3, x plus 29, and then the product is 360 according to given. Then you simplified, you get x square plus 32x minus 23, and this is the answer. Question number 2, part 6. Sorry, 4th. Question number 2, part 4th. See beta, we have done exercise 4.1 up to question number 2 part 3rd, and this is your last question of the exercise. See beta, this, first of all, before going to solve this question, 2-3 things we have to discuss, I want to discuss with you, that is the distance, time and speed relation. See beta, distance, time and speed relation. See beta, this is the kind of question. See, very frankly, 90% questions in quadratic equations will be there where you will get a fixed distance. See, let me give you an example. See, I am from Hisar, Haryana, okay, and I am working in Sikar, Rajasthan, okay. Suppose, I am telling you, I am not giving the exact figure, I am telling you, suppose, this is mathematics, you can assume anything. Suppose this distance is 300 kilometers. This distance is, sorry, 300 kilometers. Okay. Now, there is a person, person one, who started to move with 50 kilometers per hour journey. Whose speed was, person one, speed was, person, this is a case of person one, speed of person was 50 kilometers per hour. How much time will it take? 300 by 50. See, beta, in 1 kilometer he goes 50. In 1 hour he goes 50 kilometers. In 6 hours he will go 50 into 6. 300 kilometers. It means time one will be 6 hours. Yes or no? Done. Suppose person two is moving with the speed of 100 kilometer per hour. 100 kilometer per hour. Now if you see, speed is doubled, na? Speed is doubled here. How much time will it take? 100 into 300. It means for this case, the time will be 3 hours. Now you see, beta, as we increase the speed, time is decrease. What does it mean? Time and speed are inversely proportional quantities. If I am increasing this, this is decreasing. I am increasing this, this is decreasing. That case is called as inversely proportional. Okay, beta. If we increase the speed, time is decreased. If we decrease the speed, time is increased. Okay, beta. This is the fact we have to keep in our mind while tackling such kind of problems. Okay, beta. Whenever you are dealing with the questions based on speed, time and distance, always remember, time increase, speed decrease. Speed increase, time decrease. This is the fact. Okay, beta, and you have to keep this fact in your mind by this practical example. If the speed was doubled, time was halved. Okay, beta, if the speed was doubled, time was halved. There is a ratio relation in between those also. But we will not to deal with the ratio relation, only simple concept that speed and time, if this is increased, this is decreased, this is increased, this is decreased, inversely proportional. This is the only relation we have to keep in our mind while dealing with such questions. Okay. In every question, whatever is the type is there, I will make you learn about the facts slowly, slowly. In this question, this fact is used. That's why I just told you the fact. Okay. Wherever the question appears, whichever the kind of fact is used in that question, I will explain it to you with respect to the question. Do not get worried. Okay. Now, everyone read the statement. The statement is, a train travels a distance of 480 kilometers at a uniform speed. See, beta, what is given here? Distance is 480 kilometers and the train is traveling the distance with a uniform speed. We do not know the what is the speed. Okay. If the speed had been decreased 8 kilometers, see, beta, what is less here? If the speed had been 8 km per hour less, it means speed is decreased by 8 km per hour, okay? Then, what the time will be? It's obvious, speed is decreased, time will be increased. Yes or no? Speed is decreased, time will be increased, okay? Yes or no? Done? See the question, question number 2 part last, statement states that a train is covering a distance of 480 kilometers with a uniform speed. If the speed is 8 kilometers per hour less, it would have taken 3 more hours to cover the same journey. form the quadratic equation. Very, very, very simple, beta. The sums more than this simplicity are not there, beta. Very, very simple question. See, I am taking two conditions. This is the usual condition. See, try to understand. Later on, I will tell you how to write in the notebook. This is the usual condition. I am just trying to make you understand. This is the another condition. Or you can say, this is the usual condition. This is the by chance or whatever is the what? Second condition. You can write here, here.
Condition.
See, always remember relation is time is equal to distance by speed. Speed is equal to distance by time. And distance is equal to speed into time. Yes or no? Done. We will use this here. Why? Because the comparison of timing is mentioned here. You can use it very easily. See, I can use any of these. But I am focusing on the comparison, on the unit whose comparison is mentioned here. The comparison of time is mentioned here. See, beta. Usual condition means let usual speed be x kilometers per hour. Yes or no? Therefore, beta, usual time will be distance by speed. Yes or no? It means 480 by x hours. Yes or no? This is the time taken by the train at usual speed. And usual speed we consider is x kilometer per hour. Now see here. And then decreased speed is, what is x minus 8? Yes or no? Kilometer per hour. See beta, decreased speed is x minus 8 kilometer per hour. In this case, time has decreased speed. See beta, TU means I am just taking my own variables. Okay, just to make you understand. This is time. You should not say that, sir, TU, TD, what is there, full form, and these are not mentioned anywhere. I am using my own symbol to make you understand easily. This is time at usual speed. This is time at decreased speed. Time at decreased speed will be D by S. D by S. Yes or no? So much hours. Done, beta. You got my point. Total distance was given as 480 kilometers per hour. It was 480 kilometers per hour and it is fixed in both the conditions. Okay. Then usually the speed we consider is x kilometer per hour. Therefore time is 480 by x. Then the decreased speed will be, see beta, according to given speed is decreased by 8 kilometer per hour. That's why usual speed minus 8 will be the decreased speed. Okay, now see, time at decreased speed will be d by x, s, 480 by x minus 8. Okay beta, now see, the time difference is there and it is given 3 hours. You can read the statement. Everybody please just give a view to the statement. If the speed had been x kilometer per hour less, it would have taken 3 hours more. Okay, beta. It means when the speed is decreased, time is more. How much more? 3 hours. It means this time and this time having the difference of 3 hours. And the fact is, which time is larger? This or this? This one. Okay, beta. It means time at decreased speed is more than time of usual speed. And the difference is 3 hours. Yes or no, it is given or not? Yes or no, beta? Okay, now see the condition you have achieved. This is the fact, beta. Once again, I am repeating. Usual speed we considered x kilometer per hour. Speed became 480 by x. then decrease speed will become x minus 8 because according to the coding statement, and the time will be 480 by x minus 8 because time is fixed for both the speeds. This time is this one. Here the time was this one. This is at usual speed, this is decreased speed. Here time is more and the time difference is 3R according to given. Okay beta, here you can write A to C according to given. Okay beta, now see. TD is 480 by x minus 8. 480 by x is equal to 3. Yes or no? Done beta, very good. Now you see, if I take LCM here, x minus 8 into x, here is 3 by 1. I am not taking the LCM of both sides. Just take the LCM of each sides, sort them, then cross multiply. That makes little bit easier. That reduces the chances of mistake of those students. And all of you are good. So beta, you can do by yourself also. Calculation part is yours. Now see, this into this 480x minus this into this 480 into x minus 8. Yes or no? Yes or no, beta? Done. Now see, if we write this.